Alright, it's time for the final level in Fantasy Land. I mean, the final level in Fantasy Land. Area 6, Cinderella's Castle Mystery Tour. And the game's not going to let up here, that's for sure. Welcome to the final level. What's with the magic mirror? I thought that was from... No, why? Wait. Oh, it is from Snow White, not from Sleeping Beauty. Anyway, I just attack the mirror, and you get an item roulette. Oh, hey, an invisibility, nice. But I don't need it. Not even useful, because I have to... You make these spike, moving spike traps. And they're right above bottomless pits too, so I can't just gasp whenever I want. I have to maneuver carefully, or... And make sure you do not hit one of them in mid-air. If you do, you won't... Recover. You'll fall to your demise. Did you get past that? Oh, what's with this fish for? First, I have to worry about these armors. Go away. Oh, hey, it's a nice sign to lose. And a switch. This does nothing. Something to do with the scientist's lair? What? Oh hey, now there's a floor in the hole in the floor where the fish is boring was. Fall down it and it with upon him. Now the pathway's open. The sixth one's just beginning, folks. Armor. This dimly lit room is... You have to deal with some armors and ghosts coming out of the coffin. And you have to attack the lights too with the water balloon. That's why some green footprints will appear by some... by a random lock. Oh, hey. And believe it or not, the room loops. Although the lights you doubt to stay gone. You have to use a gas balloon to fly up. Oh, God, this part! Not this part! You have to maneuver through some ice. Room full of spikes. One feed their eyes, they'll wash. They'll fling down some water balloons. Create some safe frozen platforms. But hurry! The platforms won't stay for too long. Down. think there's a one up in there. Okay, the witch says it's open anyway. Well, let's find out. Never mind. Yeah, there's a one up. I don't think the loud area is going to let up, because 6-2 is not any easier either. Trolls, at least the trolls are 6-3 hits each, so they're actually the least threatening of enemies here. But the problem's here. Swing past this quickly. The less time I spend in the water, the better. This way, be sure to swim down the center to avoid the spikes. Gasoline time! Don't forget to use the air also, and watch out for the troll ambush. And these things would still provide more experience than internet trolls. Seriously, I get only one experience for one internet trolls. A group of them in there. Anyway, use a gasoline to get through that nonsense. Yeah, it's a leap of faith. And you have to get past this iron wall. Trust me, it's not the worst one. You have to get past this duck move. At least this one can be cheated out. Cripple the trolls. Step on the switch to trigger the platform. Careful movement will win the day. That way you don't get ambushed by something unexpected like that darn troll. Here you want to use a gas balloon to get around the spike and say a flow when the platforms are and making them impossible first. And here's a pressure plate switch. Get through here quickly. That was good, but luckily, oh hey, the mirror's back. And what's it doing? Why is something from Sleeping Beauty here? Oh, it's from Snow White, not Sleeping Beauty. What am I thinking? Oh, whatever. Pressure plate, and yes, it's pitfall. They fall down in. Mini-boss time. I have to fight this guy riding a dragon head. Watch out for the goo shot from this guy. Luckily the shots fire at the same angle. The problem is that the goo shots can be fired high. And they will destroy your water balloon. You need to bounce off on contact. The high shots are obnoxious because it's difficult to get the timing down right. I mean, you could move to the right of them, but that makes it harder to attack this guy. Hey. And yeah, I'm jumping right into the center of the goose shot. Too close. Too close again. Take that!
Come on, do something different.
Well, if smoke appears like that, he just turned red. And you'll have to watch out for red soldiers, as well as Pete using a sudden gust attack to push you back. Goodbye. Which doesn't matter because I can beat in the game anyway. I'll have what with annotations. 419,700 points. Nice. And Nikki's reunited Pluto. Nikki's giving Tokyo Disneyland Great Adventure is a good game. Especially with the whole balloon business. The balloon business was what got me interested in the first place when I saw YouTube videos of a no damage run. Something real. I'm sorry, I can't get its name right. Yeah, it's a decent game. I mean, sure it has flaws, but... the balloon... balloon gimmicks... are well implemented. I gotta get back to my sliding horse. Oh yeah, no, that this quick play took barely over 100 minutes. So, yeah, it's that short, even on the hard. And that... it's worth giving a shot. I think we should name it out. Let's play Mickey's Tokyo Disneyland Adventure. See you next time.